A health scare in the United States Senate now serving as a reminder Democrats have literally no votes to spare. New Mexico Democratic Senator Ben Ray Luján is in an Albuquerque hospital today. The 49-year-old Democrat, quote, began experiencing dizziness and fatigue on Thursday, according to his chief of staff, and the senator was found to have suffered a stroke in the cerebellum. He subsequently underwent decompressive surgery to ease the swelling. Senator Luján is, his chief of staff says, resting comfortably and expected to make a full recovery. That statement, though, did not say when he might return to Washington. Our reporters are back with us. And Sungmin Kim, it just gets to the point. Number one, we wish the senator well. Number two, his colleagues do seem to say their early indications are that he'll make a recovery here and should be back in the matter of a few weeks. But it just reminds us, at a very consequential time, the president's trying to get his agenda back on track in the Senate. He's a couple weeks away from naming a new Supreme Court vacancy. This is not a moment the Democrats have 50-50. This one sends a little shivers through them.
Right, and it's just such a stark reminder of the fragility of the 50-50 Senate and the Democratic majority. I actually asked Senator Dick Durbin, the second ranking Democrat, about this earlier this week, because Senator Durbin has been fond of saying all year, you know, since 2021, that we are just kind of one heartbeat away from losing the majority. And especially with the Supreme Court nomination on the table, they are, I mean, for the past year, you know, senior senators, the leadership, the staff have been working and trying to push their agenda as quickly as possible, as if there's no tomorrow. And right now, there's a lot of obvious concern about Senator Luján, his health, when he can make a return to the Senate, and also just what this means for their agenda. They're plowing through some lower-level nominations right now. They are getting Republican support for those positions. But what about a Supreme Court justice? How does that go into President Biden's calculation? All very, very key questions that we're going to be watching for.
All right. And Abby, Senator Chris Coons telling our Capitol Hill team, this is a reminder, Senator Luján's setback here, the 50-50 Senate with important work in front of us. Any unforeseen or difficult developments can make that harder. The wish list, and again, you just heard the conversation with Isaac and Manu about, you know, Senator Chuck Schumer trying to navigate this 50-50 Senate. They want to pass a Russia sanctions bill. They hope that's a bipartisan bill. Supreme Court nominee, they hope to get a few Republicans. We'll see. Build Back Better Act, can they revive it? Voting rights bill, can they revive it? I know there's a lot of anger in the Democratic Party. Why can't they get these things done? Senator Luján's stroke is a reminder here that 50-50 is incredibly hard.
Yeah, it's really difficult. And I think for all of those agenda items that they want to accomplish, it was going to be hard anyway. The real anxiety about the Supreme Court nominee is in part because there's a fraction of this timetable that is right in President Biden's hands. He has to decide who that nominee is, and what kind of timetable he's on to do that makes a big difference, because the Senate has a process, and some of that process can't really be short-circuited in a certain way. And so that's why you're seeing a lot of Democrats saying, okay, on this thing where we have some control over half of the process, we should get a name on the table as quickly as possible so that we don't leave anything to chance.
And Julie, this is your wheelhouse. This comes, and again, we wish the senator the best. It comes at a time you see the raw emotions in the Democratic Party. Senator Manchin just this week saying, in his view, Build Back Better, that big Democratic spending social safety net plan, he says it's dead. That's his four-letter word for it, dead, to which Bernie Sanders says, if Mr. Manchin chooses to side with corporate America on this issue, that's his business. But for me, and I think millions of Americans, we have to fight for the needs of working families. So you have this raw moment in a Democratic caucus that is 50-50, now nervous a little bit about one of its members.
Well, right, and you had the reminder of sort of the fragility of the majority at the same time that we have the reminder that the effect of that is that any one senator, like Joe Manchin, has effective veto power over pretty much anything they do, because Joe Manchin's unwillingness to go forward with the reconciliation bill, with the Build Back Better bill, is the reason that it is dead or on life support, or depending on who you ask, completely collapsed. He's the one who has been holding out, along with Senator Sinema, of course. But there is a lot of animosity, a lot of rage on the left toward him, and a lot of, resentment within the caucus that he's been standing in the way of what they want to do. But I think Abby's completely right. On the Supreme Court, it really is a matter of time. The Luján situation reminds them of that. And he is a relatively young man, let's not forget, by the standards of the Senate, where nearly half of the Senate is 65 or older. And they have the majority now. They have it by a very, very, very thin margin, and there are a lot of Democrats who feel like they just need to go forward as quickly as they can on the things they do have 50 votes for before that evaporates.
Right, and we certainly hope by the end of the month or so we see Senator Lujan back here in Washington. We wish him the best.